Hello everybody, this video is about hyperparameter tuning using Crib search cost validation. So as we usually do, we load the data. To load the data, we need to import pandas library. Import pandas as kd. Then we are going to read it. So the data, I call it flat. It's about flat, flooded area. So pandas pd dot read underscore csv. The flood data is found here. So flooded area, flood area. Flood area dot CSV. Okay, so we run the code. So let's see. Flood dot describe. Okay, this gives us the descriptive statistic as well as the quantile of the data set. So area here is the flooded area we want to analyze as our response variable, and all the remaining variables are taken as independent variables. So let's see. Let's type flood dot shape. Okay, we have 4017 observation and the 20 variables. So there is time, you are going to exclude time, so we'll be taking 18 variables as the predictors, and the flooded area is our regression. So now let's prepare the input and the output data. To do this, you need to import NumPy. As np. Okay. Now let's deal with the output first. Output data for feature. Collegial regression. Also call response variable. dependent variable. So this is, as I said, is array. So y equal np dot array. Flood, and we take array, the flooded array. Okay, sorry, I missed y here. Okay, y dot shape. Rows of observations. So let's deal with input features or predictors. Or again, regressors. Call also independent variables. So this we call them x equal we take an array np dot array from flood we take all the rows all the rows and we start from as you see here SH specific humidity up to the last climate variable we have here it is latent heat flux. SH, and then latent heat flux. We are slicing here. If we slice it, we need the dot lock. Okay. We run it and we see the shape of x. X dot shape. Okay, so we have 18 columns representing our 18 predictors. So now let's split the data into test and to train and test data set. To do this, we needed to import from sk learn dot model selection import train test split. So x train x test y train y test equal train test split x, y, test size equal 0.3. Okay, the steps here is splitting the data set. Here is importing the function. Okay, this is already done. Let's run. Let's see the content of the split data. Xtrain shape 2811 observation. Xtrain, sorry, xtest dot shape. Okay, let's say white train is going to be the same as X train. Okay, so this is done. We are going now to create our cross validation scheme. To do that, we need to import the k-fold. So from sklearn dot model selection and then we have our object false equal k fold and number of splits. We can fold cross validation. We take shuffle as true, so we need to shuffle it. Then random state 100. Okay. The next step is to specify the hyperparameter to tune. To do this, we have our object hyper underscore params equal brackets and the curly brackets number of features to select the quotes number of features to select. So the colon comes after the quotes. You have a list range from 1 to 18. Okay, we already have our hyperparameters methods specified. So we are going to perform the grid search cross validation. Search cross validation. Grid search. So we need to specify the model. To specify the model, we need to have the linear regression method. So from sklearn dot linear model import linear regression. So we need the function and then we instantiate the model lm equal linear regression. This is instantiation. Then we fit the model. The point first. So lm dot fit. We are going to fit it using x train, y train. The next step is to create the recursive feature elimination. Model we are going to create, we apply it on the linear model. So we need to import the RFE from the sklearn.feature selection. So we create our linear model, we fit it on X and Y plane, and then we apply the RFE on the linear model. So the recursive feature elimination equal RFE LM. And then the next step is going to call the grid search cost validation itself. And to do this, we need to import grid search CV from scikit-learn model selection. Okay, I missed underscore here, sorry, selection import search CV. Okay, so the next is to specify our model CV for the close validation. We apply it here, grid search CV. Estimator equal RFE recursive feature elimination. We have param grids equal hyperparams. We specify above. Scoring, we take the R2, CV, post validation, we have the polls, specified, and the variables equal 1. This is for the visualization, and the return train score, we set it to 2. Okay. We run. Grid search, okay. Okay. Sorry about that, grid search here. Here there is issue also hyperparams. Okay. Good. So you're going on to fit the model. Model CV. Sorry. Dot fit this model. Go here, we fit it on X train, Y train. Okay, this is fitting 10 folds for each of 17 candidates, totaling 170 feet. Okay, that's good, it's already done. Now we are going to output the CV result. CV results equal the pandas data frame so we have model CV. This is our model dot CV result plus validation results. This cross validation result with underscore here, this is the name of our model. Dot the CV underscore results underscore. This is an object. No, this is not the object. This is the attribute of pandas data frame. So this is the model. The object we created here. CV, then dot CV underscore results underscore. This is an attribute of the pandas data frame. Okay. So let's output our CV results. Many of a lot of information, 17 rows and 31 columns. And go to the headers to see. So we have the test scores and we have also the training scores split. So since you have 10 folds, you will have test scores from 1 to 10 and the training scores also from 1 to 10. The best way to see it in a very comprehensive way is to take the mean. So let me type print np.min of CV results. So it's going to print the means for us. Okay, so means for test scores, we have the means, the mean fit time, the standard fit time, the mean score time, the standard score time, the parameter number of features to select. So we have the splits for the test score from 1, from 0 to 9. And then we have the mean test score here, 0.59, and so on. And we go to, this is the rank test score, and we go to the train score, and you see the split, same thing, from 0 to 9. And we have main train score, the mean train score, sorry, 0.60. The mean test score is 0.59. and main trend score is 0.68. Okay, thank you. It's good. So we are now going to plot the result for the visualization. Okay, we need to import matplot. Lib.pyplot as plt. We need to set the figure size. So plt dot figure fix size equal, let's say, 12 and 6. Okay, then we plot the CV results, plt.plot, CV results, parenthesis, for CV result we take the brackets. For the parameter of the features to select, number of features to select, and we are going to take the mean test score. So CV results, brackets, mean test score. So this is going to plot the test result. So we will be having, we'll have this same cut off line, this time just changing the mean test result in main train result to plot the mean train result. So this what you have here is the mean test result. Main test CV result, okay. Let me specify plotting the main test CV result. The main train CV result. Okay, plt the plot CV result. Params. number of features. To select, CV results. Train score. Some new S here. Okay. Instead of nin. Okay, good. So in blue we have the main test result, cross validation result, and in orange here you have the mean cross validation for the train data. Okay. So next step is going to have our labels. So plc dot x label. Number of features. This is the x-axis label. Right here, number of features. Now plc.y label. It's the optimal number of features. Okay, optimal number of features. So what do you see here? It's like when you get here, there is no change anymore, around 12. Here it's okay, everything changes up to here. It increases. But around 12, after 12, it's like it stagnates here, it doesn't change. So I consider, based on this curve, that the optimal number of features is equal to 12. So I'm going to take 12 number of features to continue to build another model. Instead of taking all the 18 we have, we only have 12. So 6 features are eliminated recursively. So we don't need all the 18 features, but we need other 12. So let's continue. We can choose the optimal value of number of features to to build a model. I choose 12. In my case, I okay. So number for features optimal equal 12 and features optimal 12. Building a model. So we are going to use slightly the same process. We are going to have our linear model, fit linear model, and apply the grid search like recursively, application of the recursive feature elimination on the linear model. Then for linear regression instantiation, after we instantiate we fit it along the fit on x train and y train. Then we take the grid search model our case feature elimination equal RFP. Linear model, our number of features to select, which is a number of features select is going to be our number of features optimal. And then we fit it. RFE.fit. On X train, Y train. Now we are going to make prediction. So RFE is symmetrical linear. This is our symmetric. the number of features to set is equal to 12. You set it, you set the number of features optimal. Okay? That's what you get here. So, making the prediction. Flooded area on test data. Swipe it equal ln dot pred dot predict, sorry, and x test. Let's output the ypred. This is the value of the predicted value of the predicted area, the flooded area in test data. Okay. The predicted value of the flooded area. Okay. So now let's have the score on the test data. To do this, we need to import a scalar because we need the R2 score. Okay, so now let's have our R2 equal scikit-learn.matrix dot R2 underscore score, and we have our y test and y pred. So we need the R2 on y test and y pred. So let us print it. That's 0.75. Let's say 0.76, 0.75. Test score 0.75. If we go back to the values of the score for the test, the mean for the test, mean test score 0.59. Okay. Let's say 0.60. 59.75. Okay, this is how we perform the grid search cross validation to train the parameters when you have a lot. So thank you for watching the video. I hope this will help you.